Hello students. So students, in the previous part of the video, we have discussed our exercise 8.1 of chapter number 8, that is Introduction to Trigonometry from class 10th NCERT. Okay. So student, in that part we have covered exercise 8.1, and today we will start a new topic, that is trigonometric ratios of some specific angle. Okay. So what is the meaning of trigonometric ratios of some specific angles? Student, specific angle means those angle which you can already construct. Okay, which you can construct, like 0 degree you can construct, you can construct 30 degree, you can construct 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree and so on. Okay, so we have to find trigonometric ratios of some specific angle. Some specific angle means that angle can be 0 degree, that can be 30 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree, and one more, that is 45 degree. Okay, so in class 10th we have to find only the trigonometric ratios of these angle only, means the angle lies between 0 to 90, only that much value we have to calculate. Okay, so we will start for the trigonometric ratios of 45 degree. Okay, we will start our topic, that is trigonometric ratios of 45 degree. It is the subtitle. Title is this, and it is the subtopic, that is trigonometric ratios of 45 degree. In the first part of the video, student, I told you that any type of trigonometric ratios are associated with some angle. Like if you are writing sine, then sine A, where A is an angle. Similarly, tan A, then tan is a trigonometric ratio, A is the angle. Similarly, cos A means cos is a trigonometric ratio and A is the angle. Means whenever you write sine A, cos A or tan A, okay? So this thing is known as, sine cos tan is known as trigonometric ratio. And this is, A is known as angle. So the meaning of trigonometric ratio of 45 degree is that we have to find the value of sine 45 degree, cos 45 degree and tan 45 degree. Okay, this we have to calculate. Okay, so let's start how to calculate. Very simple proving is there. Okay, so just see it. Suppose, student, for finding the values of trigonometric ratios of 45 degree, we take a triangle which is a right angle triangle and it is also a isosceles triangle. It means that we have to take a isosceles right angle triangle. So how we will make it, student? Suppose this triangle ABC is a right angle isosceles triangle. Right angle isosceles triangle means the triangle should have one right angle and it should have two equal sides. So if it is a right angle isosceles triangle, so its AB and BC will be equal. Okay, if it is a isosceles right angle triangle, then its AB and BC should be equal and one angle will be 90 degree. Okay, so for finding the values of trigonometric ratio of 45 degree, what we will do? Let's triangle ABC is right angle isosceles triangle in which angle B equal to 90 degree. You can take any triangle, any angle 90. So I have taken angle B is 90 degree and AB equal to BC, because it is right angle triangle also and it is also an isosceles triangle also. Okay, so this, and we all know that for finding the trigonometric ratio we need right angle triangle. Okay, because trigonometric ratio can be applied only in right angle triangle. So we have assumed these much things, okay? And one more thing we will assume, let AB is equal to BC equal to A. Suppose I have assumed that AB is also A and BC is also A because both are equal. So suppose this is also A and this is also A. ठीक है? So now you tell me, student, if it is a isosceles right angle triangle and angle B is 90 degree. So see, AB will be equal to BC na? AB will be equal to BC. So if AB is equal to base BC, then angle opposite to the equal side are also equal. So it means that angle A will be equal to angle C. By these assumption, we can say angle A and angle C will be equal. Because in isosceles triangle, two angles are also equal. And what are those angles? The angle which are in front of equal side are also equal. So in front of AB, angle C is here. In front of BC, angle A is here. So these two angles will be equal. And what will be their value, student? Their value will be 45 degree. You can calculate. It will come 45 degree. Okay? Because suppose this is x and this is 90. And we know that in a triangle, or sum of all angles equal to 180 degree. So when you will solve it, you will get angle C is also 45 and angle A is also 45. So suppose it is 45 degree and it is also 45. Suppose nahi, its value will be 45 degree. Now, this much things we have to done. First, we have to take right angle isosceles triangle. You can assume any angle equal to 90 degree. I have assumed B and two equal sides, that will be BC and AB. And we have assumed let the length of AB is small a, so the length of BC will also be small a, and angle C and angle A will be equal, so their value will be 45 degree. Okay, now student, triangle ABC is a right angle triangle, na? Triangle ABC is a right angle triangle. Okay, so student, if it is a right angle triangle, so we can apply Pythagoras theorem. So by Pythagoras theorem, we know that na, hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. So in this triangle, what will be the hypotenuse? Hypotenuse square will be perpendicular square plus base square. This is the Pythagoras theorem. And in case of this triangle, AC is our hypotenuse. So AC ka square will be equal to AB ka square plus BC ka square. Okay. Now, AC square will be equal to, the value of AB is A, so it's A square. And it is also A, so it is also A square. So the value of AC square is equal to 2A square. So the value of AC will be under root 2A square. So it will come AC will be equal to under root 2A. Okay. So the value of AC will come under root 2A. Okay. So all side we know that AB is A, BC is also A, and AC is under root 2A. Now we have to apply the trigonometric ratio. Okay. So after this, what you will write? So in triangle ABC, we can apply trigonometric ratios. Okay. We can apply all types of trigonometric ratio in this triangle because this is a right angle triangle, and trigonometric ratio can be applied only in right angle triangle. So suppose, and trigonometric ratio, whatever angle are associated with trigonometric ratio, these angle in this case are acute only, because 90 we are calculating for 45 degree. So either we will take for this angle or we will take for this angle. So suppose I have taken C. Suppose I have taken angle C. So if I will write sin C, suppose student, sin C. अगर यहाँ पे C नहीं है, B है, तो कुछ भी हो सकता है. Suppose I have taken sin C. So for this angle, what will be the perpendicular, student? For angle C, the perpendicular will be AB, and hypotenuse will remain same, that is AC. So in place of P, means perpendicular, we can write AB, and in place of H, we can write AC. ठीक है? So I hope it is clear to you. So after that part, I'm going to write here. Okay? So see. pause the video then write. Okay, now so sine c equal to student c, sine c equal to the value of AB. What is the value of AB? The value of AB is A and the value of AC is root 2A. Okay, and C, what are the measure of angle C? What is the value of angle C? The value of angle C is 45. The value of angle C is 45. Either you can take C or you can take A because both are 45. So I have taken C and the value of C is 45 degree. So in place of C, I can put 45 degree. So sine 45 degree equal to this A will be cancelled. So upside will come 1. So it will come 1 by root 2. So that's why we say that the value of sine 45 degree is equal to 1 by root 2. Okay, all value you have to remember, student, all values. Okay, now if we can calculate sine, then we can calculate what? Cosec also. So if sine 45 degree is 1 by root 2, so what will be the cosec 45 degree? Cosec 45 degree, cosec is the reciprocal of sine. So if sine 45 degree is 1 by root 2, so cosec 45 degree will be only root 2. Okay, so if you can calculate 1, then you can calculate its reciprocal also. Okay, so sine 45 is 1 by root 2 and cosec 45 is root 2 only. Okay, these are the values of 45 degree. Okay, for sine. Similarly, student, if we can calculate for sine, so we can calculate for cos also. We can calculate for cos also. So in this triangle, again, I am not going to write. So if I will apply cos C, so cos, now I am writing directly. For C, for this angle, what will be the base? We know that cos theta equal to base upon hypotenuse. We know na, base upon hypotenuse. And in this case, base will be BC and hypotenuse will be AC. So cos C will be equal to BC upon AC, and the value of BC is A and the value of AC is root 2A. Okay? Now, because we are taking for angle C and the value of angle C is 45 degree, so we can write cos 45 degree is equal to this AA will be cancelled, so it will come 1 by root 2. So by that we have also calculated the value of cos 45. Okay? And the value of cos 45 is 1 by root 2. And we know that sec theta is the reciprocal of cos theta. So from here we can say sec 45 degree is root 2. Okay? Sine 45 degree is 1 by root 2. Cosec 45 degree is root 2. Similarly, cos 45 is 1 by root 2 and sec 45 is root 2. Now, 10 is left. So when we will apply 10C, so tan theta is known as perpendicular upon base, and for angle C, perpendicular will be AB and base will be BC. Okay? And the value of C means the measure of angle C is 45 degree. So tan 45 degree is equal to, we can put the value of AB and BC. So A by A, so its mean value is 1. So tan 45 is equal to 1. So if tan 45 is 1, student, so cot 45 is also 1, because reciprocal of 1 is also 1. So by that we have calculated, put the value of all trigonometric ratios of 45 degree. There are 6 trigonometric ratios and we have calculated the values of all 6 trigonometric ratios of 45 degree. Okay? Basically, meaning is that if you can calculate sine, cos and tan, then you can calculate the remaining 3 also, because the remaining 3 is the reciprocal of the first 3. Cosec is the reciprocal of sine, sec is the reciprocal of cos, and cot is the reciprocal of tan. Okay? So these value I have calculated for all trigonometric ratios of 45 degree. So these all values are for 45 degree. So these value you should remember. Okay? This value you should remember. The main thing is that you should know in the starting part which triangle we have to take. In this, for 45 degree, we have to take isosceles right angle triangle. Okay? So please note down, student. And this value you should remember also, because it is very useful to solve the question. Okay? so please note down it. After this, I will tell you the trigonometric ratios of 30 degree and 60 degree. Okay, so please note down it. Now, student, we will calculate the trigonometric ratios of 30 degree and 60 degree. Okay, this is also very simple. So again, we have to take one triangle. So for calculating 30 degree and 60 degree, means for calculating the trigonometric ratios of 30 degree and 60 degree, we need to take a equilateral triangle. In this case, we have to take an equilateral triangle. So suppose I have taken an equilateral triangle like this. Okay? ABC, triangle ABC is an equilateral triangle. Okay? So if it is an equilateral triangle, its sides will be equal, its all sides will be equal. Okay? And what we will do, student, because we have to calculate what? Trigonometric ratio, na? So for calculating trigonometric ratio, we need right angle triangle. So what we will do, student? From A to side BC, we will draw a perpendicular. B means we will draw a perpendicular like this. Okay? And suppose this is point D. It is clear, student? Now, suppose, student, what I have done from the starting. I am starting let. I said that let triangle ABC is an equilateral triangle. What triangle? Equilateral triangle. Okay? So if it is equilateral triangle, so AB will be equal to BC will be equal to CA, and suppose these are equal to A. This all are equal to A. So this AB will be also A. This BC will be also A. And this AB is also A, BC is also A, and AC is also A. Okay? And what we have done? And AD perpendicular BC. This thing we have done. Okay? This thing we have done. Now, can you prove, student? Can you prove triangle ABD is congruent to triangle ACD? Yes, you can prove it. Triangle ABD will be congruent to triangle ACD. Now, this thing you have to prove. I will not tell you, because in the 9th class, we have told you how to prove two triangles congruent. So these two triangles will be congruent, student. Okay. So I am going to write directly how they will be congruent. You can prove it. Okay. So triangle ABD will be congruent to triangle ACD. Okay. Triangle ABD will be congruent to triangle ACD. Easily you can prove. How you can prove, student? When you will take these two triangles, so this angle will be equal to this angle, that will be R. Similarly, this AB will be equal to AC, that is X, that is hypotenuse, and AD will be equal to AD. So these two triangles will be congruent by RHS method. Which method? RHS, right angle hypotenuse side. Okay, so this thing you have to write. This thing you will do by yourself. Okay, I am not going to write. But directly I have written triangle ABT will be congruent to triangle ACD. And if they will be congruent, student, suppose they will be congruent, so by CPCT I can write now. By CPCT, BD will be equal to what? CD. If they both will be congruent, BD will be equal to CD. Okay? And the length of BC is A, so we can say BD will be equal to CD will be equal to A by 2. Means they both will be half-half. Means this is also A by 2 and this will also A by 2. Okay? BD and DC will be A by 2, A by 2. Because both are equal, so their value will be A by 2 and A by 2. Okay? One more thing, student. Because I have told you, triangle ABC is a equilateral triangle. So in equilateral triangle, all angles are 60 degree. So I can write now angle A will be equal to angle B will be equal to angle C. All will be 60 degree. Means this angle is 60, this angle is 60, and complete A angle is 60. Okay? And because we have proved these two triangles will be congruent, so by CPCT their corresponding parts will be equal. Na? By CPCT their corresponding parts will be equal. So this angle means angle BAD will be equal to angle CAD again by CPCT. So I can write now by CPCT angle BAD will be equal to angle CAD, and what will be their value? Their value will be 30 degree. Kyunki angle A pura 60 hai. Angle A is completely 60 and they both angle are equal. So it means that angle BAD and angle CAD will be 30-30. Okay? So it clear that this angle is 30 degree and this angle is also 30 degree. Okay? See, this thing you can write only when you will prove this two triangle congruent. So this step I have written directly. You have to write the step also. You have to take these two triangles and you have to show them they are congruent. Then you will write this thing, okay? So after this point, you will prove triangle ABT and triangle ACD congruent. And after that, you will write by CPCT is this. BD and CD will be A by 2. Angle A, angle B, angle C is 60. And by CPCT, angle BAD equal to angle CAD. So now see, student, these two triangles are congruent, na? So out of these two triangles, you can take any one triangle. Because these two triangles are right angle triangle. These two triangles are right angle triangle. Okay? So out of these two, you can take any one. Okay? So now, in triangle ABD, angle ADB is equal to what? 90 degree. This angle is what? 90 degree. Now, we have to calculate the trigonometric ratios of 30 degree and 60 degree. So first we will calculate for 30 degree, okay? So for 30 degree, student, see, in these two triangles, student, what we can say, we know all the values of sides. BD is A by 2, CD is A by 2, AB is A, and AC is also A. But we don't know the value of AD. So first we will calculate the value of AD. So in this triangle ABD, by Pythagoras theorem, I can write hypotenuse square is equal to perpendicular square plus base square. Okay? For this triangle, hypotenuse will be AB, so AB square. Perpendicular will be AD, so AD square. And base will be BD, so BD square. Okay? Now, put the value of AB. AB is A, so A square will be equal to AD square, we don't know, so let it be AD square, and BD is equal to A by 2 ka square. Okay? So now we have to calculate the value of AD square. So AD square will be equal to A square, and this will be go to this side, so it will become A square by 4. Okay? Now AD square will be equal to, now you can solve it. So LCM will come 4, so it will be 4a square minus a square. So AD square will come what? 3a square by 4. So what will be the value of AD, student? The value of AD will be under root 3a square by 4. So when you will take the square root of 3a square by 4, the value of AD will come root 3 by 2a. Okay? The value of AD will come root 3 by 2a. So this value will be, AD value will be root 3 by 2a. Okay? So all values we have calculated, student. Okay? First, we have drawn an equilateral triangle. Then we draw a perpendicular, that is AD perpendicular BC. Then we have proved these two triangles congruent. After congruency, we have equated their equal side, means BD equal to DC. And angle BAD is equal to angle CAD. After that, we don't know the value of AD. So by applying the Pythagoras theorem in any of one triangle, we have got the value of AD, that is under root 3 by 2A. Now we have to calculate the value of 60 degree and 30 degree. Okay. So first we will write these things. I am going to erase because all data I have shown in the figure only. Okay. So now see. Very simple proving is there. Just if your concept is clear, then you can prove easily. Okay. Now see, what I said for calculating the value of 30 degree and 60 degree, we can take any one of these two triangles because these two triangles are similar to each, means congruent to each other. And in this triangle also 60 degree, in this triangle is also 60 degree. In this triangle one angle is 30 degree, in this triangle also one angle is 30 degree. And side are also equal. Okay? So from these two triangle we can take any one triangle, okay? Because both are equal. So let in triangle, I have taken triangle ABD. In triangle ABD, angle ADB is equal to what? 90 degree. ठीक है? Angle B is 60 degree and angle BAD equal to 30 degree. ठीक है? So firstly, I am going to calculate the value for 60 degree. ठीक है? So for 60 degree, I have to take angle B. So if I will apply sine B, I am going to apply sine B in this triangle because I have mentioned the name of the triangle, that is triangle ABD. So sine B will be equal to what, student? Sine B will be equal to sine theta is equal to perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So for this triangle, perpendicular will be what? AD. I am going to write directly. Okay? Sine theta is equal to perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So for this triangle, perpendicular will be AD and hypotenuse will be AB. Now, what is the value of AD? The value of A2 divided by the value of AB is A. Okay? And angle, the value of angle B is 60 degree. So sine 60 degree will be equal to what? See, this AA will be cancelled. So what is left, student? Only 3 by 2 is left. So sine 60 is equal to root 3 by 2. Okay? And if sine 60 is root 3 by 2, so what will be the cosec 60? Cosec 60 will be 2 by root 3. Cosec is the just the reciprocal of sine. So by this we have calculated sine 60 and cosec 60. Similarly, when we will do cos B for this angle, for B angle, cos B equal to cos theta equal to base upon hypotenuse. So in this triangle, base will be BD and hypotenuse will be AB. Now put all the values. B is 60 degree, BD is A by 2 and AB is A. So AA cancel. So what will left? Cos 60 is equal to 1 by 2. So if cos 60 is equal to 1 by 2, then sec 60 will be 2 only because sec is the reciprocal of cos. Similarly, when we will take tan B, so tan theta is equal to perpendicular upon base. So in this case, for this triangle, perpendicular is AD and base is BD. Okay? Now put all the values. To tan 60 is equal to 60 degree is equal to the value of AD is root 3 A by 2 and the value of BD is A by 2. Okay? So AA cancel, 2 cancel. So what is left? Only root 3 is left. So tan 60 is equal to root 3. So if tan 60 is equal to root 3, then cot 60 means the reciprocal of tan is cot. So cot 60 will be 1 by root 3. So for 60 degree, we have calculated all trigonometric ratios of all trigonometric ratios, okay? Means we have calculated sine 60, cos 60, tan 60, cosec 60, sec 60 and cot 60. If you know basic 3 trigonometric ratio, means if you know tan 60, cos 60, sin 60, then you can easily calculate the remaining 3 also, okay? So now for 60 degree we have calculated. Listen, student, for finding any trigonometric ratio's value, you should mention which type of triangle you are taking. If you are taking this triangle, then mention the name. So firstly I have mentioned the name, then I'm up, देन आई अप्लाइड द कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ ट्रिग्नोमेट्रिक रेशियोज. ठीक है, नाउ फॉर 60 डिग्री वी हैव कैलकुलेटेड, नाउ फॉर 30 डिग्री वी हैव टू राइट. ओके, सो ट्राइंगल विल बी सेम स्टूडेंट, ट्राइंगल विल बी सेम. Now, for 30 degree we have to calculate. So triangle will be same and the value is still same. Now for 30 degree we have to calculate. Means for this angle, for angle BAD we have to calculate trigonometric ratio. So see, if I will write sine 30 degree in this triangle, triangle ABD means triangle ABD mein, if I will write sine 30. So for 30 degree, what will be the perpendicular student? Perpendicular is the side opposite to the acute angle. So 30 degree, and in front of 30 degree, which side is there? BD. So for 30 degree, BD will be the perpendicular and AD will be the base. Okay. So I am going to write sine 30. So sine 30, sine theta is equal to perpendicular upon hypotenuse. So in this case, perpendicular will be BD. So BD upon hypotenuse is always same upon AB. ठीक है, so now the value of BD is a by 2 and the value of AB is a, so a and a is cancelled, so the value of sin 30 comes 1 by 2. ठीक है, so if sin 30 is 1 by 2, so cosec 30 degree will be 2, because cosec is the reciprocal of sin. ठीक है, similarly if we will calculate cos 30 degree for this angle, cos 30 degree, so if cos 30 I will write, so for 30 degree base will be AD, the side associated to the acute angle is known as base, so because hypotenuse is still same, so AB is the hypotenuse, this is the perpendicular, so this will be the base, so cos theta is equal to base upon hypotenuse, so cos 30 is equal to AD upon AB. ठीक है, and value of AD is √3a/2 and the value of AB is a, so a cancel, so cos 30 comes √3/2. So if cos 30 is √3/2, then sec 30 will be directly we can write 2/√3. Now two more is left, that is 10 and cot. So 10 30, so for 30 degree perpendicular will be BD and base will be AD, so BD upon AD, so 10 30 is equal to, the value of BD is a/2 and the value of AD is √3a/2. ठीक है, so a cancel, 2 cancel, so what will be left to student, 1/√3 only, so the 10 30 is 1/√3. So if 10 30 is 1/√3, so what will be cot 30? Cot 30 will be √3 only. Okay, so by that we have calculated the trigonometric ratios for 30 degree as well as 60 degree. Okay, all values you should remember. If you remember basic three trigonometric ratios of some angle, so you can write the remaining three also, because if you know sin 30, then you can write cosec 30, because cosec is the reciprocal of sin. Similarly, if you know cos 30, then you can write sec 30 also, and similarly if you know 10 30, then you can easily write cot 30. Okay, so I hope it is clear to you. So now this thing you can write. After this I will tell you the trigonometric ratios of 0 degree and 90 degree. Only two is left. Okay, so please note down it. Now student, the last part for today is trigonometric ratios of 0 degree and 90 degree. So there is no need to prove for 0 degree and 90 degree, because it doesn't come or doesn't ask in any examination. Okay, but you should know the values of 0 degree as well as 90 degree. So I am going to write directly. Okay, so for sin 0 degree the value is 0. ठीक है, sin 0 the value is 0, cos 0 is equal to 1, tan 0 is equal to undefined, infinite or undefined, we can write. In some book, in undefined is written, and some book infinite is written. Okay. Now these three na. So what will be the cosec 0? Cosec 0 will be infinite, means undefined. This value you have to remember. Okay. Similarly, sec 0 will be 1, because if cos 0 is 1, then sec 0 will also 1, because sec is the reciprocal of cos. And cot 0 will be, sorry, tan 0 is equal to 0, student. Here I have written wrong. Tan 0 is equal to 0. Cot 0 is infinite, which is undefined. Okay? It is for 0 degree. And for 90 degree, I am writing directly. Sin 90 equal to 1. Cos 90 degree equal to 0, tan 90 degree equal to infinite, that is undefined, and cosec 90 is 1, sec 90 will be infinite, that is undefined. And cot 90 equal to 0. Okay. If you remember these three values, na, first three values you know, then you can write the remaining three. Why it is comes in infinite, student? I will tell you. Cosec is the reciprocal of sine. Okay. So, agar aapko maan lo cosec 0 nikalna hai, cosec 0. Okay. So, cosec 0 will be 1 upon sine 0. Means cosec 0 will be the equal to 1 upon sin 0, because cosec theta equal to 1 by sin theta hota hai. So aise hi cosec 0 will be 1 by sin 0, and the value of sin 0 is 0, so 1 by 0 comes. Aur aapko bhi pata hai na, jab aap rational number prove karte ho to uska denominator 0 nahi hona chahiye. If any fraction or any rational number has zero denominator, so it's mean that it is undefined. It means that it is undefined. Whenever you see 0 in the denominator, it means that is undefined. And if it is undefined, so the value of 1 by 0 will be what? 0, infinite or undefined. Infinite ko undefined bolte hain, theek hai? Kyunki 1 ko jab 0 se divide karoge to infinite times bhi nahi jayega. To isliye undefined bola jata hai. Aise hi tan 0 kitna tha? 0. To cot 0 kitna aaya? Infinite. Kyunki is case mein kya aa jayega? Cot 0 equal to 1 by tan 0, and the value of tan 0 is 0, so 1 by 0 will be undefined. Similarly, sin 90 is 1, so cosec 90 is also 1, because cosec is the reciprocal of sin. Similarly, cos 90 is 0. Agar cos 90 is 0 hai, so what will be sec 90? Sec 90 will be the reciprocal of cos 90, so 1 by 0 will also come, so again it is infinite. And tan 90 is infinite, then cot 90 is 0. How? Because cot 90 will be the reciprocal of 1 by tan 90. This can be written, and the value of tan 90 is infinite. Now see, 1 by infinite, if you see infinite in the denominator, so whatever will be the numerator, its answer will always equal to 0. Agar aapko denominator mein kabhi bhi infinite dikh jaye, तो उस फ्रैक्शन का आंसर हमेशा क्या होता है? जीरो. क्योंकि इनफाइनाइट के कंपैरिजन में वन क्या है? बहुत छोटी क्वांटिटी है. दैट्स व्हाई कितना होता है इसका आंसर? जीरो. अगर आपको डिनोमिनेटर में जीरो दिखे, इसका मतलब अनडिफाइंड, और डिनोमिनेटर में इनफाइनाइट दिखे तो इसका मतलब जीरो. ठीक है, तो आप खुद से देखो यहां पर जब टेन 90 इनफाइनाइट था, तो कॉट 90 विल बी 1 बाय इनफाइनाइट, और 1 बाय इनफाइनाइट इज इक्वल टू 0. सो दिस ऑल वैल्यू यू शुड remember, student. Okay, you should know the value for 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree. Okay, all values you should remember. So student, I have taught you all trigonometric ratios for 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree. most of the student will think, sir, why have you not proved for 0 and 90 degree? Because it is not needed, okay? There is no need to understand this concept, just you have to know the values, okay? So, for all values means 0 degree, 30 degree, 45, 60 and 90 degree, we have calculated trigonometric ratios. So student, in your book, at page number 185, I don't know at which page number in your book is given because mine is old one. So you can check, before exercise 8.2, there is one table has been made, okay, in which the value of sine 0, 30, 45, 60 and 90 is given. So that table you have to draw in your book, okay, that table in your copy, sorry, in page number 185 in my book, in your book it can vary. So before exercise 8.2, there is one table is given in which the value for all trigonometric ratios of 0 degree, 30 degree, 45 degree, 60 degree and 90 degree is given in a table. So that table you have to write in your copy and you have to memorize all the values. Okay, you have to memorize all the values, because if you can memorize all the values or if you understand these concepts, then you can easily solve the next exercises. Okay, it will be very helpful for you. So that's it for today. In the next part of the video, we will discuss some question based upon this topic. Okay, so I hope today's whatever things I taught you, it is clear to you. In next class, we will solve some questions based upon that concept. Okay, so till day, have a nice day, student. Take care and solve the question properly. Okay, thank you.